Hi everyone, so welcome to this part of our series on minor progressions, where we are going to explore the dominant chord, which is that middle chord, and what all it can do, all the possibilities, basically all the ways to embellish, probably the chord which can be embellished the most in music, which is the dominant chord, okay? So I've put together a few options. These may not be all the options, but these are things which I really like the vibe and the sound of, and which I feel are the go-to kind of possibilities for my kind of music, as well as various kinds of artists who I follow around the globe. So in our chord progression, and if you haven't already, do head over and watch all the other parts, or at least part one, to get acquainted with the chord progression. And you'll find that our chord progression is G minor, A major, D minor. It's a minor chord progression, or derived around the minor tonality or the minor scale. So you go G minor, A major, D minor. Okay? So it's that A major, which is what we call as the dominant chord, and our goal in this video is to spice up that particular chord, the A chord or the A major chord. Okay, now you may be arguing, why didn't I take A minor? Because in a D harmonic minor scale, you will have an A minor, which is the 5 minor, right? But I'm choosing A dominant, or A major rather, so that it kind of really has that leading connection or that leading tone, which takes us to that D minor. Or you could look at A major as being borrowed from the D harmonic minor scale. Okay, so you have A. The first way to color it up is just by using what's called as the dominant seventh chord. Okay, take a major, add the dominant seventh note. What is the dominant seventh note? To form it, it's G with respect to A. Right? Sounds a little bit tense, right? That's the point. It's supposed to resolve to the next chord. So you have A, C sharp, E, G. Now we look at this as a major chord with a flat 7. In this case, G. A, C sharp, E, A, C sharp, E, G. Okay, so that's your dominant 7th chord, okay, which resolves to the tonic. So far we have the predominant chord, and there were a lot of colorful things which were done with the predominant chord, so head over to the earlier parts. Part 2 and part 3 will really guide you with various predominant chord colors. That's the first chord of this progression. I talked about E diminished, G minor, some bigger chords, you know, or bluesy chords. So head over to those parts and check those out before you come here, or you can follow along. The first chord, predominant, then the dominant chord you could voice like this on the piano. I quite like that. I don't like playing it all together. Sometimes it's tough for me to play all the four notes with one hand, so I kind of divide it. You can do A, E, then G, C sharp. Sounds quite nice. Or A, G, C sharp, E. You can do it that way. Or a more common way is this way or this way. You take the root and the fifth in your left, and either the 7 flat or the 3 in your right, or 3 and the 7 flat at the top. So that's your dominant. So so the dominant 7th chord sounds a lot more usable and a lot more sophisticated, right? If you remember that melody we've been working with, resolves back to the minor tonic. So that's your default shape, your 7th chord shape. Okay, now how do we color that up further? Another nice chord which I really enjoy using is the 7 sus4. So you go A D E G. How did we create that particular chord? This is the normal dominant 7th chord, A dominant 7th. To create the 7 sus4, knock off the 3rd and play the 4th. So A D E G. That's another great way to color it. So okay, now let's look at a couple of other options which you may not have heard very often, right? So you can do this way. I really like that one, where you don't play an A major or an A dominant, you play an A augmented. So how do we form an augmented chord now? You take a major chord and you sharpen or you raise the 5th interval. Take the E, E sharp is who? F. Right? So it creates this very, very dreamy and confused kind of sound, right? Resolve it back to minor. So that's another way to color the dominant. Instead of playing vanilla A major, we do A augmented. Okay, then there are a few other shapes which I want to leave with you. The other thing could be take an A7th, A major with the dominant 7th, and add the flat 9. Okay, but you need to voice it well. So you can voice it like that. And the flat 9 is nothing but the 2nd note of this of the from that root. The 2nd flat rather. This is the normal 2nd B, go down a flat to B flat and play it amidst all the other tonalities which already form the 7th chord. A, C sharp, E, G, B flat. Okay. So this is normal A major. You could play it like this. A, C sharp, E, G, add the B flat. I love that. So da de da da de da, oh, that's the flat 9. Flat 9, you could play it higher if you want to. Da de da 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 de da. Da de da da. It really elevates that sound, okay? You can also visualize an A7 flat 9 as maybe playing A, G here and then adding a chord you may already know, like maybe an E diminished or an E diminished 7th, right? There are many ways of visualizing it. So for now, this is a way I would go with A, G, C sharp, E, G at the top and then add the B flat with your thumb. Or you can knock off the G because it's already repeated. Just do that, or E, G, B flat. Basically a diminished triad in the right hand and A and G in the left hand. So a few more colorful options for the dominant chord. I'll just play you and then explain. Okay, what is that now? That is basically playing a B flat minor voicing in the right hand and an A7th in the left hand. Rather, a very clear option where you do A and a G. This is like an A7 flat 9 because you have that flat 9 there. And you also have this interesting sharp 5 sound, right? And another thing with these dominant chords is you could also play that rather weird chord, which is B flat minor over A7th or A7th flat 9 sharp 5, if you will. You could play that, then resolve it to normal A7th, which I taught you at the beginning of the lesson, and then resolve to D minor. So you could look at the dominant itself going in two stages or two phases. So it also inspire your melodic soloist or your vocalist to kind of come up with different different phrase ideas. That's the
flat 9 going to root
A,
B flat A,
and the F provides that augmented tension or that sharp 5 flavor. So I've added essentially an A7th with that augmented note F and the B flat. So good way to visualize this is play B flat minor in your right hand and play A G in your left hand. Resolves quite well. Another thing which I like to use quite often is to play, well, I'm just calling it F sharp major in your right hand and an A dominant 7th in your left hand. Lot of tension if you ask me. We call it like an A 13th because that's the 13th interval, F sharp. 13th is also like the major 6th played up the octave after the dominant 7th. You have the major 3rd. And then, of course, you have the flat 9, which already gave us that tension. So, resolve it maybe to the dominant and then back to tonic. Right? I'm going to also link you up to one of my album songs called When the Mice Play, where it's pretty much everything on this minor tonality, and I'm trying to build up at least what I think is a very, very interesting theme and these really interesting, sophisticated, sometimes surreal themes can't really come from the major scale. You'll have to go a bit beyond. And minor scale is a great start, you know, to build these very surreal, very nostalgic kind of sounds or very out of the world, dystopian kind of sounds, right? So, I like that. You can visualize that chord as F sharp major in the right and an A7th in the left. It's actually like an A flat 9, A7 flat 9 add 13. And yeah, these are pretty much how ways in which you can color up the dominant chord. And the dominant chord is a very, very colorful chord. There are a lot of possibilities to shape that. I've also talked about the predominant chord in the earlier parts. If you haven't already, do check that out. So this lesson was about how you color up the dominant chord over a minor chord progression. And moving forward, we just have the tonic chord, the tonic minor chord. So let's dive in to the tonic chord, but I'll leave you with the dominant chord for now so you could digest this information. And once you got a hang of it, do head over to the next part and we are going to talk about the tonic chord and how to color it. There are also quite a few notes for these lessons. Do check that out with a booklet which I've made on Patreon. It'll also be great if you can head over there and support our channel. It'll really grow with your help. Cheers, catch you in the next one.